Welcome back already to the TI4 SEA Qualifiers presented by Monster Energy. We're about to hop ourselves into game number two. Fear has rejoined us and moving into game number two. Looking back to game one, I feel we saw the Treant again. Treant didn't work out too well. Mythtrust just... What are they picking Treant for?
I don't think it fits their playstyle. Yeah. I feel like Tree is the hero that's an aggressive type of playstyle hero.
Yeah.
So if you pick Tree and your plan is to like play 4 Protect 1, I think it defeats the purpose of the hero entirely.
Okay.
So I don't want to see them pick Tree again, because if you're not going to play aggressive, you're not going to be really aggressive and take that initiative. I don't think it's a good pick for you. But I do like MVP Phoenix's pick, picking the Warlock. Heroes like these early push with the Warlock, the Furion. Heroes like this is really good for their playstyle.
Yep. And as far as what Mythtrust gave MVP, they banned out like the Death Prophet, some of their other pushing heroes. Do you feel like that was the right approach for the draft with Mythtrust as far as their bans are concerned, or should they look to just give them the Death Prophet?
I think it's a good ban. Like, ban anything that's like really cheesy and that you can push. Like, I predicted like MVP would take game one, kind of cheese them, and then prepare now. Yeah. I'm like, okay, they're gonna want to do this early type of push style against us. We need to be able to repel it a little better.
Are you surprised that Mythtrust lost in the late game though? It was a 50 plus minute game and they lost.
It's surprising, but that's the power of Warlock too. Like, Warlock with the Ags Refresher is really hard to deal with.
Okay. Suns fan Sindarin, do you stand by your predictions? Do you think Mythtrust can bounce back? Obviously, your prediction.
Do you stand by your
2-0
prediction? 2-0 Myth.
It's gone.
I think it's 2-0 MVP.
Oh,
Mythtrust played like
that's called bandwagoning.
I just feel like they're the most predictable team in qualifiers. They've outplayed everybody that we've watched, and they did not outplay MVP Phoenix. And you're talking about how they're going to come prepared. What are they going to like? They pick the same heroes for the most part. That's the problem with MVP Phoenix or with Mythtrust. But
okay,
we'll see.
Sindarin, do you think Mythtrust can? I mean, obviously, it can bounce back. Do you think it's likely, or do you? I mean, at this stage, MVP up 1-0, so they have an edge. But
I've seen the first two picks for Myth.
And no, you can't. No.
Oh, God. I saw the first pick. I heard the first pick. I'm like, oh, God.
I was actually going to make the point that based on those two first picks, I'm still lost as to whether that's good or not for them.
Okay.
Yeah. But I'm going to stand by my prediction still. I think Myth can come back regardless of these first two picks that I've seen.
That no one knows, but
guys,
you're not gonna see them.
Yeah, we're wait till the draft's completely over. No, we'll hop ourselves in the draft. Suns fan Sindarin, let's go.
I'm the biggest flip flopper in the world of Dota 2.
It's ultra bandwagon.
I'm probably gonna change my prediction to 2-1 Mythtrust if they win this game. But I'll just do every combination imaginable, man. But bans coming out here for game two in this best of three: Batrider, Ember Spirit, Doom,
first
and Viper.
First phase Viper ban because that hero is just amazing. Fear knows it.
Yeah. Well,
it's a hero not to be.
I was actually afraid if they had picked him, we had to get like a vomit bucket for Fear because he just cannot stand the hero. But alas, we will see Treant, which everybody loves, along with the Death Prophet and Nature's Prophet. There's so many good heroes in the pool still.
Yep.
What do we have? Invoker, Lycan, which I think was banned second phase last time.
We have all the strong supports still as well. But again, we were talking about this before the game. Mythtrust are not utilizing the Treant well enough. So the question is now, with a Death Prophet pick, do they try to run this early aggression where they push towers? Because maybe then they can utilize the train a lot better. Overgrowth has really, really good synergy with Exorcism, by the way. Anything that can just hold targets in place so you can kill them is great. Sets up for an easy silence, too. I'm hoping that Mythtrust aren't just picking this Death Prophet mid and then still running for Protect 1 with the Treant, because then again, there's just a disconnect in their in their strategy. MVP are sticking with their guns. Nature's Prophet, Jakiro, they got that in the last game. And again, Jakiro, we talked about in a previous game, how good it is against Treant. And also good against Death Prophet in the sense that Jakiro is a pretty good defensive hero at holding target points with Macropyre, with Dual Breath. He's not the easiest hero to push into.
Well, and against Overgrowth, putting a Macropyre on top of that, because you have to group up to actually get the kills on the Overgrowth heroes, decent anti-synergy? Let me call it that. Anti-synergy?
No.
I'm just making
that's not okay.
God,
it's called a counter.
Well,
but it's not really a counter.
I wouldn't call it a counter, though. That's the thing.
Wraith, I get what you mean.
Morphling and Wraith can be banned. So, Lakels, what does he pick? What other heroes does this guy play?
Maybe Naga.
That's true. We've seen Naga.
But again, is that really what they want to do in this game? Do you want to play Naga? Do you want to play a carry that's strong for this part of the game?
Oh,
they're
going
to get this Slark.
Wow.
So turning it around on MVP, basically.
Okay.
Slark is such a good hero against Prophet. He can pounce out of the Sprout. He is a great ganker, coming out of nowhere and just killing the Prophet before he can TP out. Against the Jakiro, he can remove the Ice Path with Dark Pact. Can also remove the damage over time from Dual Breath with that, I believe. So, Liquid Fire, does that stick? I think you can also purge that.
Just assume that it does.
Fear says we can probably also purge that. So this is a really interesting thing for me, because you said Myth were extremely predictable. For me, this is a breath of fresh air.
Yep, agreed. Going to have a lot.
Liquid Fire cannot be purged. Dark Pact is different. Okay, we have absolutely not reached the conclusion. Thank you very much, Brian. Okay.
Excellent. Anyway, the third pick going to be coming out here for MVP Phoenix. They have their Nature's Prophet Chikiro. Do you think they're going to be... So far, it's exactly the same.
Oh, they get the Rubik again.
Exactly the same. And of course, we saw Ryzen's Rubik is just ridiculous.
He's not as good in this game, though, I feel. You can steal Exorcism, which can be powerful, but apart from that, Overgrowth is still there, of course, but... Well, maybe Shadow Diamonds is cool to steal. Rubik can regen and run around. It's almost like having a lot of strength, right?
Well, Mithras loves Centaur, and we saw what he did to Centaur last game. So I feel like if that's just for that, that would actually be
I don't think Myth will get Centaur because they're dire now, though. I think they realize the weakness of that hero. If you're dire and you want to run a solo offlane, my opinion is that in almost every case, you should be running an offlaner who can transition into the jungle if he gets locked down, or if he gets a decent start, he can actually power level in a jungle. Heroes like Darkseer, Batrider, Nature's Prophet can also go there. What else do we have coming out for that? Beastmaster, maybe, but not really the best.
He's kind of meh.
He's kind of meh. I feel like I'm missing one or two here that just don't come to mind for me, but we'll see. Doom, perhaps, could also just go jungle, but he's banned.
And
anyway.
Shadow Demon, okay.
Okay, so that's that they're sticking with. What was that? Okay, Liquid Fire can get removed by
Darkness. Beautiful.
Darkness.
We're back where we started, guys. Okay, can't be purged, but it can be removed by Dark Pact, so it's very arbitrary in that manner, which means it's Dota 2. Shadow Demon, along with the Slark, Death Prophet mid, Tramp, I'm guessing Tramp Protector is going to be in that tri-lane of sorts. Of course, you could put Slark mid and just put Death Prophet. I don't like Death Prophet in the farming lane, though, at all. Tidehunter, it's going to be a pick for MVP Phoenix, so that's their offlane.
He was really useful in their game against our Arrow, the late game they played. He went for a little bit of a weird
build. Every single item in the game.
And had beat the record on farm on Tidehunter by like 65 CS. But for MVP's playstyle, I think this is the perfect kind of offlane hero, and especially when you're Radiant. This is, again, a hero. This could have actually worked on Dire, too. He can jungle decently with the new Anchor Smash in particular. So, but this just fits their playstyle. They need their carry. It's very obvious now, so the question is which one Myth, Trust are going to ban. Slark is obviously not a choice. They have the DP. The Ember Spirit is banned, which would be a go-to hero for MVP Phoenix. So I'm actually not sure what their last choice will be here. Storm Spirit is still available, which I think is a great pickup against Mithras's heroes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I
pretty much
that.
Only has to dodge the silence, so I wouldn't be surprised to see that banned. But they're going to ban TA, which could have also worked.
Well, but as far as Mithras, you think they're going for an offlane here? What do you think about Mirana?
They could run an aggressive trial lane too. That's true.
Well, I mean, Mirana would be the offlane in this case, because they are dire after all.
Yeah, so just solo offlane, you mean?
Right.
Kind of underwhelming, especially against Rubik.
Yeah, if you do an aggressive tri-lane bot, you could just put Death Prophet or Slark, probably Slark in the top lane.
Yeah, he would do fine against pretty much anyone here. Although Tidehunter is actually decent against Slark 1-on-1 because of the Anchor Smash minus.
Yeah, but you're not really going to kill Slark, though.
No, there's no way he kills him. But overall, it's a little hard to call right now. We're also putting a lot of emphasis on Tidehunter being an offlaner here. It is also possible that they just put the Nature's Prophet offlane and farm the Tide, or put him mid. Since the last game they did put the Prophet offlane, but I believe we've also seen them playing him mid. MVP, I'm pretty sure.
How do you think he goes up, matches up against Death Prophet mid?
Prophet?
I mean, if it's Slark, then sure, but if it's a Death Prophet mid, I feel like Tidehunter's not going to do too well.
Oh, Tide, no, but Nature's Prophet against DP, I think it's fairly even. Mm. Tidehunter will... also do okay against Death Prophet if he just Bottle Crows. Remaining. He'll get his farm with Anchor Smash. Death Prophet will get her farm with Crypt Swarm, and then they'll just keep regening up. And we get the Razor again.
Big plays, Sindarin.
I am not sure what he's supposed to counter here. There's like nothing he counters in this draft so far.
Well, he can
maybe it's an aggressive trial lane, though. Maybe they're like, okay, we actually didn't utilize our Razor that well. He has so damn good synergy with Shadow Demon in lane. You start...
That's true. Disruption.
You start the static link and then you disrupt. It keeps running during disruption. It's one of the very few skills in the game. It keeps draining damage. If you use that on any safe lane carry MVP Phoenix has here, he can't fight back. And arguably with Treant as well in the aggressive. Okay, this is just, if they do not challenge this, if MVP choose to run a safe lane try, and if they do not challenge this, I do not. I cannot imagine they would not do that.
Chikiro, Rubik, Naga. Nature's Prophet, you think it's mid, Tidehunter offlane, right?
I think Tide is mid and Prophet is offlane, based on the heroes, the
you
players
could
playing
potentially
heroes,
even put Naga mid this game.
They can
too.
Do both things. Naga. Oh, wow, it's Lakel's and the Razor, so I think he's running
Praise
it.
Praise the Lord. Okay.
What do you...
That means Slark's going to be solo, top.
Yeah, I would say just flat out, 3v3, any lane MVP puts against Treant, Shadow Demon, Razor, in my book will just lose to that lane. I cannot imagine them winning that lane. Yeah. But there is the little Joker card in Nature's Prophet, who can TP down and help out and get these kills. And remaining. As we've talked about, Jakiro can remove the living armor fairly easily, and maybe they can set up for a kill. Remaining. But at the same time, if Prophet leaves too much, this Slark is going to be out of control, I feel. My biggest worry is that MiTH Trust just run an offlane Slark into these three heroes, which I think is absolutely garbage, and then they safe lane a Razor to farm up against beating Naga late game, which they will also lose with.
Right.
So we're going to see if the teams mind game each other a little bit on the laning here, but if it's the straightforward lanes where MiTH Trust runs aggressive and MVP runs safe lane, I think MiTH Trust are going to be off to a way better start this game.
All right, well, let's go over the lineup right now. So for MiTH Trust, we have TNK playing the Shadow Demon, which I believe he played last game as well. Lakel's, this time on the Razor, as we talked about. Boombell, again on the Treant Protector, which didn't go too well in the last game again. Thank you for the zoom in. I appreciate that. Abba playing the Death Prophet and KYT on the Slark. So Abba, Death Prophet. We've seen it a little bit. It's been... hasn't worked out the greatest, I guess, but I feel like you're almost forced to be useful. God, I'm really down on Abba. I'm sorry.
You really hate that guy.
I don't hate him.
You really hate that
guy. I'm rooting for him. I really am.
And then on MVP, we've got March playing as the Tidehunter. Rubick will be handled by Ryzen. Naga Siren will be played by QO. Jakiro, again played by Heen. And Forev once again on the Prophet. So actually three of their players on the same hero as they were.
If you're going to zoom in on anything, Nature's Prophet's backpack, please. I would love to see this thing.
Right, there we go.
Look at that. He's just carrying a bunch of wood. I don't know what the point of that.
Batch of logs.
Yeah, well.
So QO as a player, is Naga Siren his type of hero? Is my question.
Well, we'll see. We'll see, Cinder. That's a great question. We'll answer that question at the end of the game, shall we? MiTH Trust is gonna
You're impossible.
Go into the Radiant Jungle. Of course, anytime you have a disruption, it's gonna be a very possible kill coming out for them. But the tier 2 tower is where MVP is gonna be lining up, so I don't think there's gonna be a first blood attempt here.
We are gonna put down an aggressive ward to begin with here, so we'll be. I'm actually not even sure if that blocks the pull. I don't think it does, but it will give vision of it. I think it's a little too far to the left. I could be wrong, though. It's kind of on the board. That doesn't block? No, that doesn't block. It's confirmed by Bulba, a.k.a. Fear. And they've got a rune ward. So the way they've warded is like obvious tri-lane warding.
Right.
You check the bottom rune, you put an aggressive ward to see the pull and or block it. Which will only see it here, which that makes sense for MiTH Trust because they can challenge it. They can just go and steal the farm and split the experience. So that's okay. Invis rune, level 1 here for TNK.
Oh, big plays.
That is
big plays.
Potential big play.
Big
if he
plays.
If he clicks it.
If he clicks it, he will.
He's just waiting
for the
And there's no vision here for MVP, so they don't know this is coming. They could be first blooding the Rubick if he goes into the jungle. But they're gonna try mid.
Yep.
I don't think they can make this call.
Well, believe Treant's
I'm
coming.
Actually confident
get,
they can't
if you can get a Leech Seed off, you never know. But of course, Death Prophet, not the greatest level 1 kill potential with the Crypt Swarm and whatnot. But they're going to attempt it nonetheless, because, well, unless they just want to stand here and Leech XP from their mid. But I doubt that's the case. QO being very, very defensive. But TNK is actually rethinking about it. What's that?
That means DP gets a very easy start here. Yep. She's going to get some free CS. Hasn't missed a single one. And unfortunately for her, she will be pushing a bit, but maybe Naga's going to negate that with the Riptide here. Overall, this mid lane, both
Radiant
heroes
Forest.
Have great mechanisms to get the runes.
Oh,
and actually,
telekinesis.
You're right. Yeah, that's first
Ryzen.
Blood.
Oh, boy. Disruption. You're dead. That's first blood going the way to MiTH Trust. Just wrong place at the wrong time, but hey, they ended up getting killed with the Invis runes, so it worked out for the best. But this tri lane, V tri lane, I guess you can call it, very odd.
Yeah, this is going to be. I think this is going to be a really hard lane for Prophet as well. Like I said, no matter what heroes MVP put in this tri lane, if it's a tri versus tri, I just flat out choose MiTH Trust to win this lane. And so far, so good. They got the first blood with Shadow Demon and Treant.
Oh, disruption again.
He's in a weird position here. Could actually be taking a lot of damage, but no ice path. Jakiro actually hasn't skilled yet.
Oh wow.
Which is a little.
What about Slark? Top lane. Slark. I was going to say he probably went. I guess he would still go Pounce first, but I'm thinking Essence Shift is actually really good against Tidehunter, so expect a lot of right clicks from him. But this is one of those lands you just don't see a huge kill potential, do you? Mm. Like, do you think it's possible for. Like, who would have the advantage? Obviously, the minus. What's it called? The minus damage debuff from Anchor Smash upon Slark, but.
He's going to run out of mana.
He can debuff
though,
that, right? Pretty sure he can debuff that.
With it's Dark a race Pack, to the perhaps,
yeah. Yeah.
But Marge is going to run out of mana here. And if KYT plays this aggressively, he's chosen to take 2 points in Essence Shift, which I think is okay. But I'm really not a big fan of maxing that. I think it's really... It delays your impact on the game so much. Sure, you can get some extra farm in your lane. You can maybe beat your opponent. But you want to max out the Pounce and the Dark Pact as
soon
as possible.
Yeah, I think he leaves it at two.
Yeah, I would think so too. We saw a game earlier in... Was it in this qualifier? That was in the American qualifier, I believe, where Slark maxed Dark Essence Shift in the lane, and it was really not useful in the game. Now March is out of mana, though, so it's going to be a lot easier for Slark here. Tidehunter, as expected, gets a slight lead in the beginning because of Anchor Smash, but he's pretty far away from getting either a bottle or Arcane Boots. So now KYT should take the advantage. He's 16 damage more than Tide at the current moment, and every time he just gets to do an attack, he gets 3 extra damage and Tide loses 1. He's actually going for Tranquils. What do you think about that?
Well, you know me and Tranquils, Cinder. Love that. Oh, Disruption along with the Ice Bath, though. Soulcatcher to follow, Leech Seed's there, Plasma Field as well, lots
high
of damage.
Wow.
Too much damage to speak of, only a 3 second lead, he'll be back very soon, but Jakiro's dead, that's 2 kills for MythTrust. And again, we talk about time and time again, this lane is just not going to go well for MVP. I mean, at this point, do you think they rotate out? Like, what exactly do you do if you're MVP?
Their problem is they have no one who can go bottom lane. They can't do anything about it. So their supports need to go and accomplish something elsewhere, or they just put a support solo bottom and get him some levels while Prophet farms the jungle. And Jakiro tries to be useful top, and it actually looks like that's their plan right now. They leave Ryzen here, let him leech whatever he can. Of course, he needs to be really careful. If he gets disrupted, he is very dead. But with this Jakiro top, maybe Slark is going to be under some more pressure. He's actually going in on March here.
Ice Path is there, so there's the rotation we were talking about. It's not going to be enough to get the kill, but it'll force Slark back. And, well, I mean, looking at the farm, 17-1 to 16-2 is still very even overall, but obviously Slark will take the advantage going forward, unless the Jakiro stays at the top lane, which may be the case. Abba gets the haste rune. We'll transition back towards mid. But yeah, we see a rotation, so I think the supports are just going to leave Rubick down there for now.
This is really intelligent play from MythTrust. They know that the supports from MVP have left, but Rubick is so incredibly scared because if he gets caught by anything, he knows he's dead, and he has no idea where the supports are. So Lakels is playing 1-on-0 in a 1-on-1 lane. Meanwhile, the supports are going to rotate top, and if they find any sort of initiation here, it's going to be a very easy kill with a Pounce follow-up, or they go in mid and catch out the Prophet.
Well, there's going to be TP support for this Nature's Prophet. Of course, I think Nature's Prophet just might just go
to
the
jungle. They're
going
to use
this
to their advantage. There's a ward here that they know is there. Oh, actually, here we go.
Disruption, Soulcatcher. Sprout's going to hold Abba in place. It's not going to really do too much. Soulcatcher, look at the amplified damage. So much damage. The right clicks aren't going to be enough. Another TP to follow for MVP as the chase continues, this time on TNK. There's the Telekinesis. Believe that this should be enough to get the kill. The right click goes the way of Rubick. So a good turnaround for MVP, forced a lot of TPs, but they end up getting the kill regardless. And they don't lose Naga, which is obviously the most important commodity.
Yeah, she had 7 armor. That's why she lived there. That's Naga Siren in a nutshell in the early
Didn't
game.
Didn't that get nerfed? Was it her?
No.
I mean, no, I know a lot. Untouched. Like in 6.8. Something.
Don't think so. Nothing about her armor.
That's the illusions, I guess.
The illusions got less damage in the newest version, right. And before that, the Riptide got nerfed, so it doesn't hit or work in BKB or something like that. But let's have a look at the lanes now. So the Razor is being left completely alone.
These lanes are so weird.
I think Lakels is going to be very powerful in this game on the Razor. This, to me, is now... Like, when I said it in the draft, that I was like, what is he countering? I wasn't sure, but it's really... It's been proving to be very useful because of the way they put their lanes.
Top lane. And have Leech Seed along with the Pounce. March very low, but of course Kraken Shell will pop, and he's just going to run away.
Slark didn't try that. He had his ultimate and 3 stick charges. He could have ulti'd, Dark Pacted, it, and hit him once. I think he would have got the kill, but playing it safe.
He's no Syndern, that's for sure.
Not going to dive the tower and feed. At the very least, he forces March back to base, who is, by the way, going for a mech with his Tranquils. That's a very greedy build, I feel. You don't really have the mana pool for that in the early game. Currently, he's losing 5 of each attribute, so he has... Let's see how much int he's going to have. His mana pool right now is 338. He can use Ravage and Mech, then he's out of mana.
Do you feel like the Tranquils are more for...
Song of the Siren mid, they're trying to go on Abba. Ravage is available.
Here we go, the TPs. Actually, it's going to be canceled. This should be a free kill on Abba, and they know it. Anchor Smash. Oh, Tree Armor's there, though.
Sure about
oh, my goodness. so much more powerful than you remember. March, continuing pressure.
That's
anchor
like
smash,
max range right
level
there.
4. Comes a disruption. TNK better be careful, though. He's the only one there. March is just going to chill.
That was an expensive. That was a really expensive kill for MVP, but I think right now they just should just take whatever they can get. They use Song of the Siren, which is a 3-minute cooldown. Ravage, which is a 150-second cooldown, so... Overall, do you think that was worth it? I'm generally an advocate of getting whatever kills you can in the early game, even if you expend.
Yeah, I mean, there's not going to be any big team fights, so Ravage on one is acceptable, I feel like.
This still means that Lakels is almost immortal right now. When those ultimates are in cooldown, I think he can't.
Do you feel like after last game, Lakels is like, just pick Razor, I'll show you how to play this hero, bro. I feel like that may be the case, as he's going to be accompanied by the Shadow Demon. Nature's probably going to go in the drum. So. Razor getting decent farm, 44 and 17. Like, I'm more interested to see what kind of build he goes for. Like, I would
love
to see Axe Refresher. Really?
He's got the point booster. Awesome. So this is really great. Awesome. I love Axe Refresher on this hero. I think it's so... It's amazingly good.
You talk about it almost as much as your Caudle Axe.
Not as much. Not at all.
Yeah. That's why I said almost as much.
I use 3/4 of my day talking about Axe Caudle, so there's only a quarter left.
The other quarter's for Fear complaining about Viper. Yeah. Ryzen. On
we
the
have
run.
We have
one
a lot
more
of
right click.
Here.
We'll do it for KYT. But here comes Tidehunter. Anchor Smash.
No
not
Ravage.
There, but yeah. Ravage, of course, is down. But either way, if it ends up being a Rubik for a
bot
Death Rocket, it's still going to be worth it, obviously. Bottom lane.
Trying to put some pressure here. Not going to get him. But now Heen could be in trouble. This is going to be a lot of damage stolen by Lakels. He's actually going to drain him completely.
Yeah, Soul Catcher. This should be like
just wait until
right
he hits him now. Oh my god, that attack damage.
And Lakels with another kill. And look at all that damage. Putting it forth upon that tier 1 tower at bot, Naga Siren. Or I'm sorry, the Dire. Splitting the gold. That's actually surprising considering how much damage Razor had, but Treant Protector now gets his Arcane Boots.
This is going to be such an early egg.
You know what's weird about last game, the Treant Protector not having a huge impact? He had Arcane Blink at like 16 minutes, I think.
He had an early Blink, but they didn't
have the
lineup. And
he had nothing the rest of the game, nothing.
Yeah, they couldn't really use it because of what they were fighting into. They like Fear says, Treant is more of an early game aggression hero. Either you win lanes by using your Leech Seed very well, or you have some solos that can exploit Living Armor really well. And this game, they actually don't. Like, Death Prophet with Living Armor is kind of meh. Sure, you can keep her alive, but she isn't really the type of hero that can really just go for dives like Reaver or something like that. Yeah, here we go. There's no song available.
Grip Swarm. Kind of getting blocked by his own illusions, but here comes Nature's Prophet
die.
With a beautiful sprout. Oh, barely goes down. Another Ravage, this time on two. They're going to pick up Boom Bell. TNK should be able to get out. Static Link, though, giving a little bit of damage to Lakels. He's going to actually try to dive this. You cocky monkey, but not going to get away with it. We'll fall back. So it ends up being a 1-for-1. Obviously, the Naga Siren being the major kill here for MiTH Trust.
Yeah. And that was perfect timing as well. Her song is available now.
Well, that
I don't know if they timed it.
That was pro. That was so
production
MVP
value.
Is green and MiTH Trust is red. That's what we know from the net worth chart right now. KYT. Applying some pressure to this top.
He immediately, he's immediately embarrassed and disconnects out. I'm done, guys. My stat didn't work.
Slarcy, first exorcism.
Yeah, this tower is gone. I'm keeping an eye on top right now where Slark is taking some harassment from the Naga, but nothing's really going to come off of this. And I think KYT will be working on a Shadow Blade here. For me, that's in most cases the best first item on Slark. It just, he's the only hero in the game where the Shadow Blade activates one of your other abilities to that effect.
Yeah,
he's just,
I mean,
so damn
number
good
one
with
hero.
Shadow Dance.
Has
he
to
is
be. Yeah.
Probably the best Shadow Blade hero in the game.
For sure.
And he will be getting that.
Oh my god, look at this stack for Tide.
Oh
he's almost done with his mech, and this will put him...
It's just so good. He takes no damage from these creeps. Look at it.
Well, it is...
Shadow Demon?
Oh, Shadow Demon is getting caught up by the Ice Path along with the Telekinesis. Not the greatest of layering, but it's not
I
really
found
them,
guys.
He finds the stack, dies, and then Tidehunter continues to farm. Of course, he has his mech, actually.
Boombell's getting some really good experience from here, actually.
What's that?
He's getting some good experience. He's stealing it from that AoE.
Ancients you don't share.
Or you don't steal
you
ancients,
don't share
never mind.
Ancients.
I'm a rookie. I was actually wondering if that was the case. I couldn't remember that.
But, yeah, Jakiro's found by Boombell. Sure the supports will come to help, but this is just like the most awkward right-click battle of all time. Lakels is there to finish him off the plasma field.
That reminds me of that gank. It's a kind of famous gank where IX Mike gets surrounded by one Treant in the early game with Nyx Assassin and he can't get out. That was kind of that. It wasn't
true.
A Treant, but it was a Treant protector.
He's a little bit bigger
so
than one Treant.
It's kind
for
of
sure.
It's a little more scary.
Beautiful net worth going the way of MiTH Trust.
Oh wow, they have such a big lead. Now, this ancient stack of course is going to go the way of Tidehunter. So he gets the mech at this point, and the top tier 1 tower will be pressured now by Myth Trust. Tide's gonna TP in, Ravage is available in 5 seconds. Song of the Siren is off cooldown, and perhaps Myth can make a play on that, but...
Oh. Actually, I'm wondering if Anchor
so
Smash...
Much damage.
I'm sorry, do you think Kraken Shell debuffs Static Link?
No.
You're 100% sure about that?
Nothing does. Okay. Absolutely nothing.
Because I know that... Oh, here we go, we have double TP's Lakels. There's the Song of the Siren.
This is a decent setup.
Are they gonna be able to... help him out though.
Oh, they're gonna save Lakels.
Sure,
I think
the disruption will come very soon.
Oh, he
Ravage.
Took the
oh, gonna hit two though. Lakels very low. Disruptions on the Lakels. He's gonna go down.
Living
though.
Armor. Living armor.
Oh, trying to run away. He's
five
gonna be
HP
burning.
One.
Burning. He finally goes down. Ice path to follow. TNK extremely low as well. Gush, along with dual breath.
He might survive this. The death. There is no, now he has mana.
Anchor smash. Goodbye. Oh, Slark, pouncing down. March is the one in trouble now.
Yeah,
taking some right clicks.
It's a good Kraken proc there,
it's
but still,
very
oh,
low, man.
Nice
beautiful ice
path
on a very narrow pathway. Alba trying to get out of the way of Slark, but not really doing a very good job at that. March, oh, nice sprout from Ferev, but March looks like this is going to be a death one way or another. And this is very anticlimactic.
The anchor smash. He's like,
so
he's
good.
Poking him with his little fish sword and dealing zero damage.
And KYT should have his Lothars.
Yep. That is a 13-minute Shadow Blade. Pretty damn good timing. And that's not just a Shadow Blade. It's with Treads, Orb of Venom, and a Magic Stick, and the PMS. So very good farm coming out in this game. And this is just a different Myth Trust. We were talking about it before the series today. They have on and off games. This seems like an on game. Sure, they could have made some better decisions, but this is just so much better than game number one.
Yeah.
And MVP, maybe they're the predictable ones this game. They picked 3 of the same heroes as last game. Sure, Myth picked 2 of the same as well. Actually, 3. Okay, great. But you know what? I don't have a point anyway.
No,
they actually picked
it's
3
different though.
But they
the
ran the lanes differently.
Yeah, the Razor pick is on Lakel, so it's
yes.
A completely different role. Death Prophet. We've seen one Exorcism, but
13
I'm sure
minute
more will follow.
On Razor.
Ags on Razor. Oh, Refresher will be so sick.
These
I hope
towers are just gone to level 2 Exorcism and that Razor. Now Slark is going to start roaming around, getting easy single pickoffs. He can kill almost any. He can't kill the Tide. I think he can solo any other hero or force Song of the Siren if he does it completely right with the opener.
Well.
This top tower is gone. I don't think they're even going to try to defend it. They're trying to trade in mid.
No need for Exorcism at top. That should be a
free
tower.
It might go
tower.
For 2 towers, actually.
Yeah,
there's no Ravage and no Song.
Yeah, Exorcism should be used on the tier 2, but... yeah, I think you're right. They're going to continue this. And March and company, perhaps... want to trade for the tier 1, but it's not the greatest of trades. Of course, Slark is actually waiting at the tier 1 mid, so not the whole team here for Myth Trust. We have some TP support, fortification to follow, exorcisms popped. March, Ravage is now up. He has the mechanism, of course. An exorcism was stolen by Rubick. Gonna see a double exorcism. I feel like Myth Trust is in the backup now.
Who's
they don't
ghost
have team
or
fight.
Who's? Where? Oh, what team am I on?
I mean, that's. I feel like that's a difficult one to steal, considering you have a very low cooldown Crypt Swarm, but. Hopefully he learns his lesson after this. But yeah, they're forced to back up because you can't go against Ravage.
He should just. This shouldn't actually be even available to steal. He should cast it out of vision and just use silence on the ground or something like that so Rubick can't get it. I think he learned his lesson from that. If it's cast in the middle of the fight, it's very easy for Rubick to steal it because it's such an obvious animation. Like the way she moves her body.
Moves her hips.
When she casts that, it's very easy to see that it comes off. And since Death Prophet's cast animation is kind of long. We steal it, Slark.
Oh my god.
Oh boy.
Wow, that song.
He's still
going to
get out,
clutch.
Though. It's.
Yeah, he should be able to get out. Pops. Oh, he's actually going to continue. Okay, I thought he was going to actually aggress.
Oh, nice body block.
Beautiful blocks. Ravage goes off. It's not going to hit, though. Huge waste. Doesn't have enough mana for his pounce, but it's not going to matter.
Okay, that was actually better than if he had got the kill for a Myth.
Agreed.
He forced Song and Ravage and didn't die. So. I'm not sure what March was expecting there. I think even if the Ravage hits, he still escapes there.
Right.
I don't know. Maybe he didn't have the mana for Shadow Blade, so... Maybe worth a try, but high risk, decent reward, I guess we could say. But
it's like Death Prophet's going for a Yules.
Yeah, I love that pickup. It's so good on that hero.
You love it.
It's like the best hero in the game to get that item on.
Yep, all that move speed. Along with the Cyclone effect, of course. Never to be underestimated. Lakels pops his ultimate, along with the Static Link.
She's one of the only heroes in the game that can deal significant damage while being Yuled, because the spirits still do full damage at the same time.
Rubick should still have Exorcism, so whenever Death Prophet is up, it should be up for Rubick.
Yeah, 5 seconds.
but they know that Ravage is down. I feel like MiTH can take this tower if they want. Of course, the Aghanim's ult.
This time
Razor.
He's not going to make the same mistake. Immediately carrying Swarm, but
yeah,
well,
there you
it's
see,
still
he's
there.
Still going to have it.
So if he runs out of cooldown and spell steal, do the ghosts disappear, or does he have it until the end of the duration? Is the question.
Oh, you're going to have to ask me after this fight, Syndrome.
Okay, no. If he
the fight's over. Say it again.
If Rubik's spell steal expires while the exorcism is running, does it disappear or does it finish its duration?
It should still finish.
I think it finishes?
Yeah. Actually. Never tested it, but it wouldn't make. I don't know. It doesn't really make sense the other way around.
I think both things make sense.
TP support from Tide with no Ravage. He actually could have gotten caught out pretty easily there, but they don't want to go against the other exorcism. So they're going to play it safe. Meanwhile, Nature's Prophet pushes top a bit and is forced out. We haven't seen Roshan come to effect here. I feel like that exorcism should have been used for that, actually. Because they have the Slark. I mean, we saw it last game with MVP being on Dire, having the Slark with the Aegis was pretty powerful overall.
Yep.
And, I mean, the sooner you take Roshan, the easier it's going to be to get to that level 3 Roshan with the... I mean, we saw Slark with both Aegis and Cheese, which was pretty huge. There's a Sacred Relic. So Radiant's coming very shortly for Naga.
It's still going to be a late Radiant, all things considered. He's died twice. They haven't taken a single tower. He has good farm overall, but it's been delayed that I would say MiTH can deal with this. The problem for them is going to be when Naga gets more items. If Naga gets to farm and we get into the late game, they don't have a counter. That's just going to be... It's going to be impossible to deal with, I think. If she gets 4 or 5 items, they don't have any significant illusion killing. They've got Crypt Swarm. They have got Plasma Field and a little bit of Shadow Poison and Dark Pact. It's not enough against a farmed Naga. But... It's kind of funny to see, right? It's like MVP has to play this game the way we were saying MiTH were going to play their games today. They have to play on the late game. It's like 4 protect 1 this game for the Naga.
Oh, Lakels gets ensnared. It's only a level 1, I believe, so he's just going to run away.
They can't touch him.
Yeah. Well, he's going for the BKB now. So
and Treant almost has the blink.
No
same timing as last game. 18 minutes.
Wait, who is that?
Treant.
Oh, okay.
Boom Bell.
Beautiful.
There's a little bit of drain from Lakels. Actually, zero.
Got what him. Did he get? Like, he got nothing.
Yeah. Wow. It takes the first second before you drain.
That's unfortunate.
That would actually be a really significant buff to Razor if it started draining immediately. So you immediately got the first tick.
Well,
I don't know if that would be
often.
Too powerful. I still think this hero is generally pretty good, but you need to see the opening for it, and then there needs to be a weakness in the enemy draft for it.
Blade
like TI3 was a really big pick, for example.
I feel like the Blade Mail on Tide's not the greatest. I mean, Exorcism, it's not exactly a normal AoE. It's kind of directed for the most part, you know? And especially with... when I look at that Blade Mail, I feel like it's against Razor, but Razor's going for BKB, so he's not going to be affected by it at
That's
all.
That's true. So but Slark can take a lot of damage, though.
Yeah, but do you really initiate onto Tide? I don't know. Mm.
I don't agree with this choice either. I think the Blink Dagger would have been better. Just you want to get in, you want to immediately take the fight on your terms. But then again, they could also just rely on setting up with Song every time. And then he doesn't need a Blink to get in. Maybe that's the logic. But if that was the point, then I still think there are just flat out better choices than Blade Mail.
And there we're seeing the Exorcism come into play for Roshan.
Yeah, bye-bye, Stone Guy.
And assuming the Aegis will go to Lakels. Actually, no, I think the Slark's a way better Aegis carrier.
He's not there, though.
But
he's in the entire base.
But it is Lakels, so he'll take it regardless, I think.
Hey, guys, Mikari.
But, well, actually, what do you think about that Aegis on Razor in general?
Does he keep Eye of the Storm through that?
I doubt it.
He does not. Okay, then it's not that good. I think Slark is indeed the best pickup then, because for Death Prophet you lose.
Well,
Death
Prophet's like the last person you want Aegis on.
She's really not that good on Aegis.
Boombell, finding March in the top lane. Actually, more are coming. Abba, does he have his Yules? I'm not sure. Silence is up on March. Static Link to follow. Blade Mail. Can they actually stop
nice
the TP? He finishes
and
Yules
now. And there comes the Yules. Like, god damn it, guys. And the tower fell.
Yeah.
That's really a big deal, because they could have healed this up to at least half health before MVP would have had another opportunity to go there with the Treant.
Can we look at the Dire Courier?
That's
crucial. That Courier was not clutch at all. At all.
What is this?
That's a lock.
Yeah,
lock,
sure, but it's a really weird one.
Great
camera control. Oh, God.
So Slark gets a kill on the back end. We can blame that on us. That's all good.
On you?
On us. We're a team, Syndrome. Any failings, we do together forever. But, yeah, the Blade Mail, questionable at best. But, not sure how big of a deal that's going to end up being.
Slark's getting Orchid.
Ooh, nice.
And he has it in a moment, as a matter of fact. He's missing very little gold for that. Will allow him to probably solo the Naga, who will else just song or use Mirror Image, but he will definitely be able to solo Naga. And I think that's the only reason he's building it here. Either that, or he wants to try to make a clutch play against Tidehunter by just Orchiding him and leaving him alone so he can't use Ravage. But that's kind of hard to pull off. There's the Blade Mail a little bit from Arch. I'm not really seeing too much.
Wow, that's a pretty decent static link, giving 42 damage. But Lekkels gets caught out. Of course, he has Aegis. But the Eye of the Storm is going to be wasted if he goes down, so he doesn't really want to get killed yet. Stuck in the Sprout, but he's going to continue on. Arch
really
taking
good
so much damage.
Whoa, wait, what?
What?
What was that? Where did Slark die?
Oh, Slark died.
He got killed down here by Naga.
Interesting.
What?
Well, either way, okay. Mistrust is going to run away. Tide didn't expend his Ravage. And the Exorcism ult was used, Eye of the Storm was used, Aegis did not pop though, so that's pretty important. Slark did finish his Orchid though before he dropped. Yeah, that's weird.
Yeah.
So another kill missed by our beautiful cameraman. Thanks a lot, bro. Mott notes.
He's done.
BKB now though on Razor, so that's going to be very helpful. Of course, keep in mind, if he pops it before the song, it could actually be pretty bad. That's one of the things you have to keep in mind with BKBs against Song of the Siren.
They can't kill him yet, though. Naga needs more items before she can kill him during that.
They don't have a ton of damage, but they do have the Ensnare, so it goes through the BKB as well.
Yes, they can control him if they get the song off, but that's mainly going to be useful another 10 or 15 minutes into the game when they can actually just flat out bring him down that way. Still, this is... I'm not sure if MiTH has got this, to be honest. Sure, they've got off to a good start, and they have a 5k gold lead, but this Naga is going to be a really, really big problem soon. That solo kill on Slark, I think, was a really big deal. Sure, he's still got the Orchid, but it's extra golden experience for Naga that she really needed. She's got a level 11, almost 12 now. And as we know, level 11 to 12 is a huge experience amount you need for that. After that, you start getting levels. That means cheap stats for her, and she'll be a lot harder to kill and will farm faster.
Right. Of course, Abba now has his Cyclone Stick, a.k.a. Yules. They're going to continue this pressure towards bottom lane. This tier 2 is in quite a bit of trouble, but the tier 1 might be traded with Tide and Rubick waiting on the wings, as they're just going to continue to push. But yeah, you're right. The late game, Naga just out. Who carries harder than Naga late game with like full inventory, honestly?
It depends how the fight goes down. There are heroes that can deal with it, but very, very few. There's a trade. Treant wants to go in, but there's no backup here. They're going to just be trading. Abba will take bottom. Actually,
Slark finds the Rubick, almost blows him up, and does actually. Song a little bit late, he's going to be forced to TP out right away. Tide,
no
though.
Mana for Yules!
Tide!
He doesn't have the mana!
How did
it's
he lose all
75!
Necro units, I'm guessing?
No, I think he just... Yeah, maybe he got mana burnt, but he really had a very little mana off the bottom lane. He's been
pushing out. I love Abba. Have I told you that recently?
Yeah, I know.
I love...
But he had been... to be honest, he used all his mana on taking this bottom tier 2 with Exorcism, and then he used 75 on TPing in. He just didn't have enough.
Right.
So that's really unfortunate there. He would have loved to Yule the Tide and get them an extra kill, but at the end of the day, they got what they really wanted. They got the tier 2 bottom. They got a pickoff on the Rubick. And how long is left on this Aegis? 1-2 minutes, roughly. So I'm imagining they want to try to press the issue a little bit here, but of course, with Exorcism on cooldown, might not be the easiest thing in the world. Yeah. He's not. Just look, Naga's already being a Pestilence.
I haven't heard that in a while. Pestilence. Wow. Mid lane, little static storm or static link action. I'm gonna combine skill names again today. I feel like Sonic Storm is my favorite though of all time.
Sonar Scream. Right?
Or Sonar. Wait.
Sonic Storm.
Sonic. Wait. What was it?
That's all
right. Sonar.
You
scream?
Were saying Sonar Scream.
Oh, okay. Well, Sonic Storm.
Which is not a combination of abilities. But oh, yeah, it kind of is.
It kind of is. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
How dare you, Syndrome, questioning my terribleness?
I think that the plan here for MiTH Trust is put as much pressure as possible, get the refresher on the Kells, and then end the game.
Nah, he's trying to use that Aegis. Of course, it's up for 30 seconds. Static Link will be used to decent effect. Slark getting another kill, this time on Nature's Prophet. The Aegis has finally popped. But of course, the Static Link damage is gone. And he's going to be surrounded. The Gush is going to hit, but he's just going to back up for now.
This is a nice play from the Kells, putting some extra pressure. There was no point in holding onto it there. Slark will get away. And this is what I was mentioning during the draft, how good Slark is against Nature's Prophet. You catch him out, he's just dead. He can only get away if he has a TP, and his TP is very, very fast, and that might not even be enough. Here's the Overgrowth.
Yeah, Static Link to full effect. Lekkels' BKB, 147 extra damage, but he's just running astray, trying to kill the Rubick. Naga Siren picking off the Treant in the meantime. March looking for that Ravage. He's finally getting that once the BKB is over from Lekkels, and there's the Ice Path to follow. He's dead! Unbelievable. Abba has to run away. Gets ensnared, though. Unfortunately, the exorcism not going to really help you too much. Dealing decent amount of damage to QO, but will not be enough. Slark, better be careful. The Necro 3 units are not in range, though. As he's going to actually try to go in. Very cocky play. Ryzen not going to go down as of yet. Ice Path is there. KYT on the run. Should be able to get out. Death Pack, or Shadow Death was actually stolen by Rubick. I've never seen that before. That should be pretty interesting. He's going to regen pretty fast here, so that's a good spell to steal.
That was a really clutch play by the Prophet there to keep Rubick alive. And every time these pushes fail for MiTH, they don't just lose the fight, they lose 2 minutes of farm. And Naga is just going to get stronger and stronger and stronger.
Well, that fight, it was...
That was just
That
weird.
Was a weird misplay by Lekkels. He tried to kill the Rubick with his BK... What? Was that a 10-second BKB, a 9-second BKB?
I think it was... That was 10.
So it was 10-second BKB, and then once it was... Once he figured out he wasn't going to get the kill, he tried to run away, as we're going to see Slark attempt to kill the Nature's Prophet, but it ain't going to happen. He's going to be forced TP. To TP out. But the Ravage, he just... Tidehunter just, like, move followed him until the BKB was up and Ravage.
The thing is, Marge has 31 armor. There's... It doesn't really matter that Razor steals a lot of damage. He's going to deal symbolic damage to a Tidehunter with 31 armor and level 4 in Kraken Shell. It's a 40 damage reduction on top of the armor. He can't die right now, basically, if he just plays it right. So he's using that to zone control very well.
Well,
I
it's
March
still the easiest here to
apart.
Steal damage from, though, at
yes.
the same point.
Sure, he's going to get the damage, but the question is if he can use it. Because Tide is just, as I said, zone controlling MiTH Trust very well. And we're going to see the same thing happen again now, perhaps. Abba with the ult.
Not much damage stolen this time. Ryzen pops his ult. Not sure why, but he picks up his Blink Dagger. We'll be here very shortly. And Abba's Exorcism. He did learn from his mistakes, so I appreciate that. This Tier 2 tower, though, not going down as of yet. Telekinesis onto Abba, taking the Gush to the face. Mech is popped. Here's the Overgrowth on March. Of course, Ravage is not off cooldown as of yet. There's the Overgrowth. Was that stolen? It was a stolen Overgrowth. Lekkels dead again, despite having the BKB activated. Abba on the run. The Radiant's damage is going to be too much. Tries to TP out. Actually, well, might be able to get away. He does. The beautiful silence on the March. Isn't able to get off his Anchor Smash in time, but TNK, you're not going to be so lucky, good sir. That's 2-for-1, but still, it could have been so much worth for MiTH Trust. So much worse, I should say. But Lekkels again going down with a 9-second BKB.
Slark wasn't there for the beginning of the fight, so... It makes a really big difference that he can't be the initiator. He needs to try to sneak around the side, find one of the supports, and pick him off before the fight begins, because there's nothing on the Radiant side that can kill this Slark. He goes in, he uses Shadowblade, he opens on a target, he uses the Orchid. If it looks like they're going to cast some big ultimates, he can always Shadow Dance. If he forces out the Song of the Siren, that's great. Then that song is on cooldown, and maybe they can accomplish something. Roche is up again. This should be an absolute free kill for MiTH. I still don't think MVP are strong enough to fight that yet. If Slark just, again... is there and goes in front. He is so farmed. 7-1. He's close to a BKB now on top of his Shadowblade Orchid. He has a lot of weight on his shoulders here, KYT. He needs to perform, more importantly than anything else, he just needs to be there.
Yeah. Well.
And now Naga with the Manta can't be soloed anymore. He missed the timing on that. He's going to try here, I think, on QO. But they don't know it's the real one. Now they do. He used the Manta. That's a big deal.
Boom Bell.
He's going to die now.
He has an Overgrowth. He's waiting for it. There we go. Slark to follow. Orchid on top
That's
of him.
QO
taking so much damage. He's going to pop one way or another. Goes down to Boom Bell's right click, which is probably the last hero you wanted on, to be perfectly honest. But the killing speed does go his way. But I have to say, MVP Rubick, Ryzen, ridiculous spell steals again. 2 games in a row.
Yeah, he's got some good ultimates this time around. 40 seconds in Naga. No buyback. They're at least going to get the tier 2 this time, I think. But... I'm missing a pipe right now for MiTH Trust if they want to play this lineup and want to end it at this point. They need to have enough to brute force, and they're just getting pushed back by this Jakiro, by the Naga Radiance, by Fatebolt, all
this
the time.
This is the third attempted push on this tier 2.
They finally get it. Maybe they try to go high ground. They might realize there's no buyback.
Exorcism
this could be
used.
Big.
Is it stolen again? It is! No, that's silence. Just chill, bro. Okay, Shiva's now picked up by Tidehunter. Double Ice Bath, a beautiful disruption, though, to save his teammate for now. Lekkels, again, so very low. Just feeling his impact is very low this game overall. And they're just going to be forced out.
Yeah, Prophet
I feel
is
like
split pushing. Meanwhile, there's the song.
Is he going to catch?
Oh, hits
Lekkels. Aye, aye, aye. And Snare to follow, I'm sure. There it is. Rubick. Nice disruption, but I don't think that's going to save him for long. Lekkels goes down for a third time, 3 times in a row. On the third push on that tier 2, which they did get finally, but I feel like they can't really push until they have Ags, to be perfectly honest.
Or you mean Refresher?
A Refresher on Razor.
Oh boy. Prophet's dead.
Get silenced. Is this enough damage? Oh, there's a Cyclone. I think that's the first time I've ever seen it used, but alas, it will be enough to get the kill.
They're gonna lose the if they lose the tier 2 tower here, though, this game is falling apart for MiTH. They're losing their lead, they're missing the timing of their lineup. And they've, sure, they got the kill on Naga, but again, she gets comeback kills, she gets more farm than everyone else. Here we go, Slark's actually gonna go in, he's silenced!
Oh boy, he gets
a big
nice
Yule.
Disruption, though. Overgrowth to follow, Boombell on the run, Overgrowth stolen again, this Ryzen is so sick! Treant's the first to fall, though. BKB is used for the Death Prophet, which is newly picked up. And now they're on the run. Can the Cyclone hit March is the question.
5 second cooldown.
Okay, 4 seconds. He's just going to farm the creeps.
They really need to chase this down. They need to get a kill, and they need to get Roche. This is theirs.
They should be able to get... Oh, they're going to go for the G0. Oh, nice 4 staff.
He's still
Static Link, not very long, but here comes the Slark to finish off. Jakiro, BKB now picked up on that Slark.
Prophet will backdoor the mid-tier two. I don't know if he can even take this. Nope.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
This is so this is so awful to watch. Holy God. And the Cyclone.
Kind of Cyclone that makes you.
Beautiful Cyclone.
Here come
from
the Naga
Lava.
Illusions. Oh, there's Living Armor. And they're going to turn the Naga Illusions on themselves here. A little bonus gold going to go the way of TNK here. Actually almost dying to Radiant.
Oh, God.
This play from Prophet might have just saved them the Roshan, though. All of MiTH Trust moved mid to defend that.
This is
the time when Death Prophet needs to go back to base and get mana. Get ready for the coming fight. She does not have enough mana for her ult. She has mana for the mech only. If MVP go in here, they can try to snipe it with the Song of the Siren, which is, by the way, almost level 3. Has Boots of Travel. But, okay, she's going to use her wand and get the Exorcism off. They will not contest this. Yeah. And this one is the second Roshan, so no cheese just yet. Aegis will go to Slark this time, like we talked about.
Right.
Probably the best Aegis carrier.
Yes. For sure.
The challenge for MiTH now is just not letting MVP out on the map. It's essentially what they have to do here. Shiva's
March.
Pop. He's got so much armor.
Yeah, it's like they don't do anything to him. There's
Overgrowth
a Blade Mail pop. Oh my
creeps.
God, Slark is taking so much damage from the Blade Mail. Overgrowth is there. Lakels, are you going to get caught out again, good sir? Boombell, going to go down to the ice. Oh, the ice path is so beautiful. TNK down, 2 dead for MiTH Trust. Again, MiTH Trust on the run, trying to steal damage from the illusion. It works?
Yes.
You can steal from illusions?
Yes.
That's ridiculous.
It's not as useful as stealing it from the main hero.
Well, true, but...
But it's still, sometimes it is the play you can
make. Well, this
make.
Tier 2's dead one way or another, despite having the Aegis. MiTH
Overgrowth
just,
gets stolen every single time.
Yeah.
Or maybe he had it again there still from the previous
Well,
steal.
That one, yeah, you're gonna have to put, like, Living Armor on somebody or something. I don't know.
Prophet's dead again. I think.
Well, TP out.
Nope, Song! And, oh, they didn't TP anyone with a stun in there, so...
I don't even think the Song was needed, but...
Yeah, I agree.
Gets out nonetheless. Oh, big plays! Lakels, big plays! So he's getting closer and closer to his Refresher. Should have the Perseverance now, and then the Recipe to follow.
And now, for the first time in this 35-minute game, the gold is favoring the Radiant by a whopping 300. Get the Roche. Oh, never mind, they already got the Roche. So they need to go and try to go mid again, I think. Use your ultimates. Does he have the Refresher? This Refresher has been delayed so much by his deaths, which I think could have, to a large extent, been avoided, but maybe they get the Prophet at least. He does have buyback, however, but he will be dying here.
Well, Nature's Prophet just keeps getting caught out. The Pounce isn't there, but the damage should be. Demonic Purge even wasted, but, again, easy pickoff for MiTH Trust, and yeah, they should transition this into a push, but Abbas caught out alone again in Snare. Pops his BKB. Is he going to be able to get out? Yes. No? Okay. He just starts to run away. Mecha's popped as well. Here comes Slark and the rest of the team.
Boy.
He's going to Cyclone himself. Exorcism is there, but he goes down right away. Buyback from Nature's Prophet. BKB's galore from MiTH Trust. Is it going to continue pressure upon March, who has not used his Ravage. He's waiting for those BKBs to...
I think we are reconnecting now. Trying to reconnect at least.
All right.
Okay, here we go.
Apologies for that delay. MiTH Trust got dominated probably, but...
They managed to kill the Tide somewhere.
Yeah, Tide Hunter somehow died.
Yeah, they got the tier 3 for that, though.
But like you talked about, the initiation on Tide is just should never be... MiTH's plan.
It doesn't make any sense. And the thing is, March is just abusing it to the limit. He's baiting them. He wants them to go on him all the time. He wants them to use all their abilities.
Well, look at their damage. They're all physical, too. And with all his armor, yes, it's not a good idea.
It's really good. The Shiva's pickup was great here. And now the Tranquil Boots. The four extra armor of that do make a little bit of a difference. Might still be the best boots choice he could actually make at this point. Can they get into the high ground, though? Song of the Siren is ready. Ravage, 90 seconds cooldown, which we, of course, missed being used
But
here.
Heart is now on Naga, so they her illusion is pretty beastly. Nice ice path, bling. The push a little bit. They have decent anti-push here with Macro Pyre and every other spell from Jakiro. And MiTH's is going to be forced back again. They're going to smoke, though, so are they going to actually reinitiate? What is this smoke for?
I don't know. The refresher is flying out for the Kells now. I think this is the last hurrah. Either you win this fight and get something, or Naga will just
Well, yeah, you can't underestimate, though.
Okay,
this is the thing.
Really
so
powerful.
What's BKB now on Razor?
It is 7, and he can use it twice.
Okay, so if Blade Mail is popped while BKB is not on, with a double Eye of the Storm, he will get decimated.
He will kill himself.
He will...
But that requires that either Tide is the only hero inside the range or that he's the target with the lowest health, which
probably won't be the
case. I think he can play around with. But considering how Lakels has been playing all the previous fights, it might be the only target in the AoE. They just keep going on this Tidehunter and it's not working for them. But now he's level 16. He has the refresher. I think with Lakels' start, he could have actually had the inventory he has now at 30 minutes, but they just messed up a couple of fights that delayed him so much. And that essentially resulted in Naga having so many items now. She has 2 slots left. She is 4 slotted. I don't know if they can do it anymore.
Is that another smoke? Oh, this time it's by MVP. So the smoke for MiTH's ended up not being needed. I guess it was just for a getaway, but Nature's Prophet is going to continue to push that top lane and pick something up at the secret shop, it seems, which is a Scythe of Vice, which is beautiful. Was it... who played the Nature's Prophet last game?
Forever as well.
Okay, so what did he go for? He went like... Scythe of Ice really, really late, which was kind of weird. But TNK getting caught out. Not even going to disrupt, just dies.
Had it on cooldown.
Oh, he'd already used it. Okay.
Used it on a Naga illusion, I think, at some point. And this is the mid push. There's no buyback from Shadow Demon. It might not sound like too big of a deal, but it really is. This disruption is absolutely huge, getting these Naga to lose.
Yeah, this tier 3 tower is down already, so this should be easy pickings. But of course, big ultimates are there for MiTH's. Soulcatcher was stolen. It's actually on Death Prophet, so you better be careful here. Of course, he does have BKB. Slark pops his. Death Prophet there. Hers is. March. Just hiding them so hard. Overgrowth
him.
Is there. And, well, damage is a little bit, but Cyclone on the Death Prophet and the Song of Siren.
Oh, no!
Terrible combination. They're going to be forced out. Tidehunter actually
dies
in this
engagement.
That wasn't
a terrible combination. That wasn't even a combination.
Well, same thing. Kyo on the run. He's going to get silenced. Can he TP out?
Okay.
Disruption is there, and goodbye QO. So, very poor coordination here for MVP.
Look, okay, try to double-click the Jakiro and double-click the Rubik and see where they died, respectively. What?
Yeah, that's weird.
Why were they there? They were pushing the mid-racks here. They were just spread out all over the place. They got picked off by the Snark. So, MiTH get a couple of bonus kills. They lost their melee... the ranged barracks, actually, so not even... Too big of a casualty there, and the Song of the Siren, Siren and Ravage, as we said, completely misused. So MiTH keeping hope alive here. I would almost say they actually needed that to keep hope alive. So MVP are being gentlemen here.
It's like a handicap that's needed, I guess. Static Link stolen, or is that Plasma Field? I can't even tell.
It's Plasma Field.
Okay, not the greatest spell, but it's actually decent for anti-pushing, I suppose.
Okay. Naga's out in 10.
Caught out with the ice path. Disruption. Macro Pyre. A blink. Is that a blink? No, he just walked in. A walk-in Shiva's. Gotta love it from Tidehunter. But mech is there as well. So MiTH's already used their mech. I think they can't really push without their ultimate, so they're just going to back up for now. And of course, the Ags refresher was used by Razor. So another 53 seconds on the refresher.
I'm wondering what item he needs to go for. I think he just needs to go flat out hard and just try to stay alive. Go in the middle of the fight, get living armored, have the heart, use double ult, and just try to stay alive. His BKB is on 6 seconds now, so he can have 11 seconds of BKB in the next fight if he refreshes it perfectly, which he probably doesn't, since he wants to run both Eyes of the Storm in the beginning of the fight. We'll see if he can pull it off. We're just starting to see Naga. I think, okay, realistically, if Naga gets her next item, Butterfly, probably, or a Defusal 2, I think the game's over.
Butterflies.
I just think the game is over.
Really good. Yeah, Butterfly would be pretty good. So, interesting stat. Average match time for the Americas is actually less than SEA. That's probably
4 minutes.
That's mainly because of MythTrust taking every game late game, I guess. But it's a little bit skewed, I'm assuming. Another minute and a half with the Roshan coming up.
Yeah, what's the average Myth game time? I would like to see that.
Disruption on the Illusion, and this is that's obviously the we talk about Shadow Demon's use late game all the time, and it's one of those heroes that just doesn't taper off that much because you can always use the enemy's carry to their to your advantage. Aghanim Scepter now in Rubick, as we talked about last game, doesn't have the best Aghanims to steal other than maybe Eye of the Storm, but it really is about the cooldown. That is definitely true. And MVP is going to group up. I'm sure a smoke will follow here shortly. Maybe not. They're grouping up as if they want to smoke, but the longer this game goes, got to give the advantage to MVP with that Naga Siren, obviously. And Nature's Prophet's going to start hitting pretty, pretty hard here.
Yep.
Smoke is finally there, and they're going to be looking into Roche, who's not quite... What is that? Yeah, what is up with the timer?
This is good. Abba has Boots of Travel.
No, I mean, the timer is just, like, not even there. That's weird.
I think it's crucial that Abba has Boots of Travel right
now. Cal's in Snare. Gosh, he's already at half HP. He's going to go down before anything happens. Does he have a buyback?
Yes.
It's going to be forced out. They might just give this mid lane, this mid rack.
He's
going
to have to use it anyway. They're just going to go for another lane until he buys back.
Okay, he buys back. Of course, they don't have a whole lot of right click for that. Overgrowth. Was it stolen? Again, it was stolen by Rubick. Tidehunter pops his Ravage.
Lucario Akuo's dying.
Is there with his double ultimate. Naga is the first to fall, though, for MVP, so you would assume they have to back up here. Despite the great play from Ryzen, they're not able to set anything up. March on the run with all that armor. It's going to take a while to kill him, but it looks as if he will go down in the end. I'm not sure how Naga got picked off so fast, Syndrome. And bottom lane is getting pushed. They get the tier 3, but it looks like that's all that will fall.
Her Manta Style was on cooldown, and Slark got in with the Orchid. This is exactly what he needs to do. Good play from him. I think if you're Naga, you just hold on to the Manta. It's the only way she can die, I believe, against the Myth lineup. She uses her Mirror Image, she pushes with that, and if she gets Orchided, she just Mantas out. And then she can sing. But
she can sing so good.
She wants to go really... I almost want to say it's greedy to use the Manta for aggressive purposes in this lineup right now.
It's true.
Just play it safe here. They did force the Ravage. Roshan is up again, this time with the Emmentaler, but I don't know if they want to even go for that at this point. They try to push down the mid. Maybe they get the tier 3, but that's all. Razor has an ult.
Yeah, Naga's up in 2, so there's only so much damage you can do. Micropyre and Ice Path. It does so much damage. KYT trying to get out. Is he going to get it? Pops his BKB if they can get this kill. Nope, he's going to pop.
That wasn't even close.
His ultimate.
Stop getting excited.
How dare you, good sir. But, of course, he's going to heal up pretty damn quick. Death Prophet's ult should be coming off cooldown about 20 seconds, so they could re-aggress. But, again, it's going to be 5-on-5. Can they replicate what they did last time? The Orchid. Maybe he learns his lesson this time.
Ravage still 50 seconds on cooldown. There's going to be double Eye of the Storm in 60.
Mistrust average match time, 41 minutes. Peace, son.
It's pretty long.
In the tournament itself. So Lakels gets initiated upon again, pops his BKB. Damage is not there though. March, nice force staff's gonna avoid the pounce. Of course, Ravage, like you said, another 35 seconds. They don't really want to commit to a fight. And you have to feel like MythTrust knows that the Ravage is down. They feel like they need to force that.
It's not enough for them to force though, that's the problem. To me, it's not so much about March's Ravage as it's about him just being alive and going in the front lines. He's causing so much problem. So very problem.
Very problem.
Very problem. Much challenge for Myth to fight into this Tide.
And now Nature's Prophet's actually doing some legit damage too. So
yeah, he's going to get the Deso. I wonder if Tide goes Refresher. Or if he just goes flat out for a heart and then just front lines even more.
I would like a Refresher here.
I think it's going to be good too. I think either is actually has...
We haven't seen too many songs into Ravages. Just because there's so many BKBs, it's not really the greatest combo.
Oh, this is huge. They're just going to steal this rush.
Are they actually going to get this?
I want to call this a steal because, in my opinion, Myth should have taken this.
They're so spread out. How are they not even close? I feel like this is huge. That's the cheese, too, right? That's the third Roche.
This is an absolute giveaway.
Wow.
This should not be happening.
Naga's, in all likelihood, going to take the Aegis. Who would you put the cheese on here? Right clicker and Nature's Prophet?
Give it to Tithe.
Okay, well, the Aegis is going to Nature's Prophet, so.
Tithe's pretty much immortal with the cheese, but they give it to Naga.
I suppose that's
she's
probably
the one who has the most health.
Yeah, so Naga, it's not like you're not going to have time to pop the cheese at some point, so. Yeah,
it's a good choice. Now she can play aggressively with the Manta if she wants. She has the cheese. Because there is not a. There isn't a single stun on the Dire to prevent her from using that cheese, apart from if Slark gets the perfect timing on the bash.
Here's the grouping from MVP. Are they going to take this 2-0? This is insane. Going up Grand Finals in this SEA Qualifiers versus Aero Gaming, which has dominated most teams. The reason I thought MythTrust might fare well against them is because the matchup they had against Aero was an absolute stomp in MythTrust's favor. So perhaps they have them figured out to some degree, but could have been a fluke like you were talking about. And again, MythTrust just, they don't show up half the time, so they're not the most consistent team. Here's some damage applied to the mid racks. Lots of illusions. Necro units as well. This is a dead racks at the Necro.
Oh, Tide's taking
there.
Really big damage here. Actually.
Blade Mail has popped as well.
Oh, big Shiva.
Shiva's to follow. Ice Path. But Slark's just right clicking. There's the
perfect
Ravage.
Yules.
Eye of the Storm is actually stolen from Rubik. So two dead right off the bat, but one of them is an Aegis, so he'll be back very shortly. Song of the Siren was used, but he'll TP out just in time.
Jesus.
So MVP not able to breach this mid racks. Actually, did they get it?
Warning, if you have epileptic tendencies, do not watch the mid lane right now, because Razor is going to town with
well,
a stun.
Well, when Lakels isn't the one being initiated upon, he just deals so much damage.
Yeah,
that's
he is
issue.
Really crazy. But that, they're starting to be able to kill the Tidehunter. What are we looking at? I am moving
I can't
my
control
person.
The camera, so I'm guessing they got mid racks completely.
They got
sure.
the mid racks.
So the Necro units
right.
did their job. So I guess MVP gets what they want. I mean, they have the late game, too, so.
Yeah, they're in no rush, honestly. This is just, like, bonus for them, being able to get the racks here, I feel. And just Nagas being so damn annoying, delaying the wave from coming in, doing significant damage to all the heroes with the Radiant's Riptide. They're going to try to go high ground now. Guess who's waiting? Mr. Macropyre.
Yeah.
And they still don't have a pipe.
Yeah, that is really weird. That is really, really weird. But Ensnare is there for Lakels. He's just going to right click.
They get the tower.
The tower.
No. Still not get attack.
They'll get it eventually, Syndra. And Lakels is actually forced out because he's at half HP already. Oh, but going so low with that Nature's Prophet's ult.
Ooh.
And Lakels, again, the BKB TP does nothing for him. Boombell dies as well. Do they have buybacks? 10 seconds left for Razor, but he doesn't even have enough money anyway. So MVP can force this into a second Rax, perhaps. Bottom lane would be the... probably the right choice. Okay, he does have buyback now.
He's going to have to expend that. Ravage is 40 seconds on cooldown. Naga can TP in with the Boots of Travel. Prophet's Necronomicon is on cooldown. Wrath of Nature, 20 seconds. Rubik, Eye of the Storm is ready in 10 seconds, which could be really interesting for this push, and pretty relevant, too. And this is a tense moment. They have to buy back the Razor. There's no way in hell he's not going to do that. Double buyback.
Now I'm questioning whether MVP
all
can Ryzen actually back
really
up here. Pounce is going to miss. Ryzen, very, very aggressive. March pops his Blade Mail, but he's taking so much damage. Cyclone to follow for the Death Prophet. Jakiro's ult not doing a whole lot with Lakel's BKB.
March lives.
But he's out in front. And the song gets everybody out for MVP. March, look how low he is. Everyone's going to get out of dodge just fine. Butterfly now on Naga, so it just gets worse and worse for MythTrust.
Oh, perfect Sprout here from Forev.
It's not going to stop that Slark.
That's a different fight if KYT hits his pounce. Because then Rubik just dies in the beginning, and yeah, sure, maybe the song comes out, but then at least they get a kill. Maybe they don't commit as many ultimates to that fight. MVP are just so good at resetting with their lineup. They didn't even have Ravage there, but just song is enough. The BKBs on Myth are now so low on duration that Song can actually be popped when they're in BKB, and it's still going to have an effect a few seconds later.
The split push is now officially redundant.
On the hunt, Forev could be in trouble here, but KYT's not finding him.
He'll be fine.
Actually going to live.
So, what do you think about him not finishing Abyssal? Gets the Demon Edge instead.
He wants the MKB against the Naga, but I'm actually not sure if that's the right call. Sure, you're going to do more damage to the Naga, which is great because you can pierce the Butterfly, but I think in this case, the Abyssal Blade might have been more useful just so they can single out a target, just lock someone down and kill them. The problem is that they're getting kited, not that they can't do the damage.
MVP smoked up. There's the MKB as you talked about for Slark. If they can take out Razor here, this might be the GG because his buyback is not up for another 4 minutes. Seeing the Leech Seed. Marsh is chilling. He's walking in with his Shivas.
Hex.
Of course, he still has his ult. He's going to use this. Going to hit two. Laquelle's very low, but Abba's going to be the choice for MVP as they take him down. He buys back right away. Not sure if he has an ult as of yet. KYT trying to chase somebody. Laquelle's is going down to these illusions, a snare, necro units. Laquelle's ice path trying to keep up from the tree and protected, but he does fall in the end. Rubick steals the Crypt Swarm, but I'm not sure if it's going to be enough. Nature's Prophet buys back. He'll be TPing very shortly. Marsh getting extremely low, but they just can't quite kill him. Abba, again, this is going to be his second death. Disruption. TNK getting extremely low as well. Abba
will
cyclone himself the cheese into effect. Ay, yeah, yay. And Abba's going to go down. This might be GG in MVP's favor. Slark was very low, but gets out the buyback from Shadow Demon. I'm not sure if that's going to be enough. This should be GG in favor of MVP. Well played. Really well played. And with this Nature's Prophet dealing so much damage on the back end, and they're not focusing him at all. They continue to focus Tidehunter. I don't know why. But either way, there's the Sheep and Snare. KYT, goodbye. TNK's the last to survive, but he's not going to do anything for his team. So this is going to be GG. MVP going 2-0. I predicted this, Syndrome. I predicted it, bro.
It's over.
So they will head up against Arrow Gaming in a best of five for the grand finals of the SEA qualifiers. But this was a much closer match than the first game. I thought MythTrust played decently overall. But
and you know what's
Laquelle's
fun about
was
this?
One that caught out over and over.
You know what's really interesting about this is that if you look back a few months, people would have said there's absolutely no way in hell there's going to be a Korean team at TI4.
That's
no
true.
Way in
That's,
hell. Yeah. And they just made it.
It's a good story.
I think beating Arrow is going to be much, much harder. I don't believe they can do it. But just getting to the event is a really big accomplishment, in my opinion, for Korean Dota, considering how relatively short time they've had, considering their scene, who have basically mostly been playing against each other and Cypher. What are your thoughts on this? I'm not sure what to say.
Korea going or this game?
Both.
Everything.
It's scary about Koreans going, because like, they've been dominating like almost every game they touch. And now they're getting into Dota, and no one expected this. Just how fast they're able to like go from like, okay, they're bad, to like, all right, they're going to TI now. It's really impressive. So it's scary. Next year, you're Korea maybe? Who knows? We'll see. But this game in particular, I thought everyone on MVP played really well. I think Ryzen, great steals as usual. March for me was the MVP of this game.
Yeah, agree
for
100%.
MVP. But like, he was really confident in what he was doing, the way he'd move. He's like just staying up in the front, knowing his limits, bought his team a lot of time, good item choices as well. And someone that didn't get a lot of credit as well as Shikiro, he was on point the whole game with
so
his
many
ice
nice
paths.
Yeah,
it was really well done. Everyone played pretty well. QO was the weaker one for me this game for MVP. His farm wasn't the greatest. It's kind of slow, but he still played pretty well. And this is a different type of playstyle from MythTrust. We don't see him play like this very often. They just didn't know how to finish. They had a great start, but since they don't play like this very often, they didn't seem like they knew how to finish the game.
Yeah, I liked they actually used the Dream Protector really well for once. Like the offensive trialing worked out. We kind of questioned the Trinity use of them a few times, but
I feel like it was more useful for MVP.
Excellent overlay.
Woo!
Getting cut off a bit there. No, it was a good start for MythTrust, but then the mid game it's just not a lineup they used to running in come mid game time. They couldn't get their objectives, and then even late game they didn't control Roshan. MVP's taking that Roshan, I think, won them the game. Then they were in a good position regardless. Like, I don't think they were going to lose without it, but that was what sealed the deal, and that was something that MythTrust should have never allowed.
So, I mean, in conclusion, MythTrust were predictable. Now they tried something else, it didn't work. They don't get a second chance, unfortunately.
Yeah. Well, both games came close to working. Like, even game one, like, their predictableness, it looked pretty good. They just kind of struggled to go to the finish line. Game two, they sang new, and it also almost worked. I just feel MVP would just, across the board, everyone carried their weight. With MythTrust, there were a few players who just didn't really step up, maybe.
That was like the one game Laquelle's was didn't have as big of an impact as we're used to seeing, I guess. I mean, once he got that BKB, it felt like every time he used it, he died. Yeah. Every single he would try to TP out, BKB, or BKB TP out and die every single time. And
kind of ironically, this was perhaps Abba's best performance that we've seen. So they just weren't on in the same games. And I think the reason we were used to seeing these games from MythTrust where they were just crushing earlier, I felt like it was because both Abba and Laquelle's were playing well in the same game. Like, we had a Dragon Knight game where Abba was doing great.
I believe
that was a really one-sided game. And then there was the game against Arrow. I don't remember what Abba played in that game. It was mainly Laquelle's.
It was mostly Invoker he played.
But this game, I think, I just felt like like Fear says, they're not comfortable with playing this kind of game where they need to end. When they had the biggest advantage, Slark wasn't there for the team fights in the beginning.
Multiple times.
He was just around the map hunting the Prophet. They fight 4-on-4, Prophet TP's in, 4-on-5. They lose it, or Song of the Siren bails them out, whatever. That Orchid needs to be there. It needs to catch Naga. It needs to win the fight.
I think the biggest mistake they made of the whole game was when they're pushing that top lane and DP actually got her ult stolen back, so they couldn't push that tier 2. Yeah. That was a huge window they missed there. And with a lineup like that, that can't happen.
Yeah,
very true.
I think end of the day for me, MVP win this series because they actually take risks as well. They MiTH Trust always sing back playing passive. It's their play style and all, but MVP, look at game one, they would just make ballsy plays. Like, even when you look at the Prophet forever dying, buying back, TPing in, it's end of the day, MVP putting themselves in the position where they can win the game rather than just play for the late game. Even game two, they were taking chances, making risky plays, whereas MiTH Trust were just playing way too conservatively all in all, and taking those risks paid off for MVP. Like, I think for the most part, they were always well-calculated ones, but It just gave them that bit of an edge because they were always controlling the tempo a lot.
So now, MVP are going to go in against Arrow.
Yes.
Which I don't think anyone in the whole studio thinks MVP are going to win this best of five. No. I believe I'm not stepping on anyone's toes if I say that.
I think they get one game maximum.
Is there a way that MVP can take that series? What should they play on? Are there flaws in Arrow's style that they can exploit? Or is it just like, we qualified, it's great, let's give it our all, but this is really a hard one to overcome. I think it is no matter what, but what do you do if you're MVP now?
I don't have a clue. I really don't. Like, they go for this kind of cheesy push style, but then that's where DDZ just plays his Tinker. Tinker fantastic at stopping that. Yeah. So I think Arrow just have too many answers for this playstyle because of their... I mean, DDZ's not that versatile with his hero pool, but the heroes he does play fits great against MVP. So I'd ask you, what did MVP do? Because I don't have a clue.
I think just cheese. Cheese as hard as you possibly can. Yeah.
Level 1 Roshan.
Bring out all of the cheese.
Okay. Well, there's always opportunity for throws from DDZ. Or overconfidence, I guess you could say. We saw that in the last series.
More
so.
Bloodstones.
Yeah, exactly. Tinker Bloodstone.
I'm a fan of the Tinker Bloodstone. I like Bloodstone.
Okay, so he actually suicided like 5 or 6 times with Bloodstone, and they still won.
That's
so
true.
It's like
the fans got 30 items. It's pretty good, right?
It's pretty good.
What
for
else
the fans.
Can you do at that point?
He's a community man for sure. That's why he did it.
What do you think, Sindarin? MVP? What do they do?
I don't know. I asked
they can
you.
Cheese. I know. That's
I
why I
throw the question back to me. You're like, I don't know. What do you think? I would agree with Fear. They don't necessarily have to play all cheese, but I think it's really important that they play lineups where they get momentum if they get a good start.
A better question. Why do they need to cheese? What makes Arrow so much better than that? MVP can only win by cheesing, as far as that's our assessment.
I think overall, Arrow are good at drafting, first of all. They have a lot of options when they go into the picks. I think DDZ... Probably that's also something that's like the common consensus in this studio, that DDZ is the best player of this qualifier, hands down, just in terms of mechanical skill, in terms of decision making, perhaps not the best, but he is really damn good in that mid lane. So just flat out from the start, if DDZ has a lane dominator and he gets to play 1-on-1, he's going to crush his opponent completely into the ground in this matchup. If it's an even matchup, he's going to win. So it's going to be important for MVP that they get either a favorable matchup mid or that they gank DDZ, else. I think he could take too much control. So that's definitely a thing to do. That's one of the main factors. In addition to that, Arrow's execution just seems... They just seem more intelligent in the game than the other teams who have been making a lot of mistakes. Like we saw in this game, it seemed like MiTH Trust were kind of spread out, like with the Slark plays. That just doesn't happen with Arrow, because they know they need to be 5 in that situation. If Arrow gets the start that MiTH Trust have in this game, Arrow wins that game. That's just the difference between those two teams.
I mean, talking about like DDZ and the skill of Arrow, I think something worth noting, I mean, it doesn't directly relate to the competitive aspect, but on the Dota 2 leaderboards for SEA, Arrow have 3 players in the top 10. Number 1 is DDZ, number 2 is Lance, and Johnny's like around number 10 to sometimes a bit lower than 10, but he's a support player, and he's still in the like top 10 on the leaderboards. How important is that, like, individual? I mean, it's pub skill, but it's still applicable in pro games, like... What would you say on that, Fear?
For them, like, it's like they're going to have a hard time shutting down all of Arrow's lanes. That's why I say go cheese. Because they have, like, it is pub skill, but they have really good laning mechanics. So I think if it's just, like, straight lanes, they're just going to lose every single time. So you need to break away the laning stage as fast as you possibly can, start pushing, and that's more into MVP's comfort zone.
I think the real question is, are they number 7 on Ursa in the world?
That's true.
Is that man right here?
Kind of the bigger question.
Number 7 on Ursa, guys. He's legit. Although he did lose his last game, so he might be out of the top 15.
I was lagging.
Laggy?
Excuse every
You've
time.
Got
it was the Wi-Fi and the servers were lagging.
Okay, sure.
It's actually true, but
the USC anyway. Servers, yeah. They've been checking. All right, so we're in agreement. Arrow Gaming, heavy favorites. You said maybe 3-1. Do people see MVP taking more than a game here?
I think they could take a game. Just I mean, one. It could be the overconfidence of DD's. I don't know. I can't get that out of my mind, that Tinker game. That was so cocky. But they have potential, like Fierce saying, for a cheese strat. They could get one game. The experience is just, I don't know. I mean, I don't know if you heard what I talked about. Loda always gives advice to, like, newer, I don't know if you want to call MVP Phoenix a newer team, but they're less experienced, to say the least.
I would say Arrow's actually the less experienced team here. Arrow's
a
young,
about the actual
yeah.
players themselves, okay. as far as, like, team composition. Yeah. But, I don't know, MVP's surprised a lot of people.
Coming into the final, though, there's I actually just sent a message, like, saying congrats to Arrow Manager. He's like, yeah, our players are really nervous for the final. Mm. Mm-hmm. They're big favorites, but they're really nervous. These guys are all very young. Mm. For MVP, they're not expected to win. I feel like there's less pressure on them, and they're also a bit more experienced. March has been around for a long time. He's played in top international teams in the past.
Has he?
Okay, Nirvana man.
He played for
six
KS,
man, but
KS. Yeah. Okay. Maybe. Okay. The March flame comes out.
He's around, but that team in particular is going to be really comfortable in a high pressure situation.
Yeah, that's what I feel. They're a lot calmer. For Arrow, I feel like they're much more young. More just people who are going to be prone to letting the nerves get to them, maybe.
Just the MVP in general. They're playing in Korea. They've been on a lot of stage matches by now, so I think they can deal with pressure a lot better than a team like Arrow can. But I think Arrow just has so much talent. Will that be a huge factor? We'll see.
Well, they're surprised for major Star choking. Too, so
That's MVP have been stomped. They've been stomped at Star Ladder. They've been stomped in the KDL finals by Zephyr 3-0. They're not going to be worried about like. Getting 3-0 stomped here. If that happens, it happens.
What about the discrepancy between Zephyr and MVP now in this qualifiers? Was anybody expecting that big of a gap?
I mean, we did our power rankings at the start. Most people rated MVP above Zephyr.
But by that much?
Not by that much. I think the one thing that separates them is the support play. MVP's support play is just they control the game.
Burn on Purge?
I don't think it's the actual individual.
You just want some drama, right?
Not necessarily the individual skill, but their move. I mean, support play basically comes down to moving around the map, and MVP just understand how to move around the map better and be more efficient. I think.
Cop-out answer. Typical gods.
What? Do you want to flame Purge? Is that
no,
what?
Well, of course. I love flaming Purge. Who doesn't?
Okay.
It's so fun.
You've got the stage.
I love Purge.
I'll give you 15 seconds.
Do you think it's fair to say? Do you think it's fair to say that Arrow are their own worst opponent in this final? Like. If they perform, if they're not nervous, if they play their game, if they don't get cocky, we were talking about like how good they are, that they're young and the inexperience could be a factor in comparison to MVP having experience and perhaps being able to pull out some better team play. I'm not sure about that.
I don't know if that's giving enough credit to MVP, though.
Do you think Arrow is their... What do you think about that statement? Arrow are their own worst opponents in this final.
Maybe some truth to it. I think it maybe doesn't give enough credit to MVP. I think the one thing which MVP, if the QI, I think has this series QI has not been the best. He's a bit hit or miss. He's been picked off a few times. I think if QI really steps up, plays a, he's gonna be the QI versus DDZ. I think that's the matchup to watch out for. Mm-hmm. If QI, I think QI's mechanics in lane are fantastic. It's his mid to late game decision making that lets him down. And that's where I feel. I mean, you're talking about the matchup. If it's an even matchup, DDZ wins it. I don't know if I'd agree. I think. I mean, we're talking about the leaderboards. QI's up there in the top 5 or so himself. So his mechanical skill. I would say it's very close to DDZ's. But that's laning stage. I think mid to late game, DDZ is the stronger player.
Okay. What about the carries compared? Lance versus... Who do we
March.
Compare him to?
March, I mean, it's March doesn't really play true carries.
Yeah, MVP
Forev
actually switch around.
Forev plays offlane, but it's like Nature's Prophet's like more of a carry than a Warlock, so...
So I still... Lance is still... For me, it's like Lance is still really strong, so even if you shut DDZ down... Lance is always playing a pretty hard Ryze for the most part most games, so you have to worry about shutting both of them down, which is going to be a hard task for MVP.
And what heroes do you ban? Like, he's played Doom fantastically. I think Doom is really good against the MVP playstyle, maybe. Like,
it could be, yeah. They play a decent amount of stuff, but I think you have to focus on DDZ's heroes more than Lance's.
Yeah, so. I think DDZ, he's like a prodigy, but at the same time that he's very young, like you talked about, so the immaturity we saw from... I'm going to keep bringing up the Tinker game over and over. It's just no discipline, I feel like. So I shouldn't say no discipline. Like a TI4 qualifiers, you'd think you'd see more in that situation. That's their worst. So I say yes. That's their worst enemy syndrome.
So
answering your question.
I guess we've kind of gone through everything.
Yeah.
Before we go, predictions for score.
I'm
going to start 3-0 Arrow.
Yeah, I mean, my head says 3-0, but...
But my heart...
No, I think 3-2 Arrow.
3-2 Arrow.
I think MVP take two games.
I'm going 3-1.
3-1?
Arrow.
3-1. Okay. Well, we were all wrong about this game. We all said MiTH Trust were going
to
win this.
You know, every time Sindarin, every time we've done predictions with you, when we all unanimously agree on who's going to win, it's always been wrong.
Almost always.
Whenever it's been, like, everyone agreeing on the team that's going to win. Or, for the most part.
So, MVP's going to win, though.
Maybe.
That's
maybe.
That's going to be a story.
That would be crazy.
Wait, we have 3-0, 3-1, and 3-2.
Yes.
So, somebody's going to be right, or everyone's going to be wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah. On that note, guys, we're going to get to a break. When we come back, the grand finals, best of five, no winner bracket advantage. Thank you for the Mort notes coming out from Suns fan as we go to a break here. It's the TI Qualifiers presented by Monster.
It's contagious, man.
We're the NA Hub. See you soon.